here's a quick little walkthrough of the Dragon Tablet, as is the backside of it. You can see it shows your buttons over there. You also have a camera and a flash on the top. So on the side, you've got a power button, and then you got two volume controls, and then there's a pinhole reset if you needed to do that. The other side, if you go to the top, you've got your power port, slot for memory card, and your headphone jack. Nothing else on the bottom, nothing else on the other side as well. And then some speakers are coined on the back there. This is the actual tablet itself. I've been using it for a while. I am an Android user. I have Android phone, so this is a little bit familiar with me. And my phone is Android 10. This is Android 9. They're not too far off, but just to be aware, if you are I'm an iPhone user, and if you're just looking for a cheap tablet, it will be just a little bit different to use. Pretty straightforward as far as how it goes. It's an inexpensive tablet, so it's not going to be, extremely fast and powerful. This is great for kids. This is great for grandparents. Or if you just want something, to read Kindle, New York Times, whatnot like that. You're not gonna do any gaming on this. You can watch a movie on it. On some services, Zoom does work. I gave that a try, but I find it a little bit faster on my phone. But that's to be expected. Like I said, they don't claim this to be a super fast product. This is an inexpensive, everyday tablet to use. But size, a little bit bigger than a cell phone, smaller than an iPad mini, easy to hold. This thing is crazy light. This is super, super light, so it's gonna be comfortable to hang on to, especially for kids. It's got a screen and a body that could probably take a beating. A case would be helpful. But, that's your basic walkthrough of it, give you an idea of the size, the ports and whatnot on there. If you're just looking for something inexpensive for just casual usage, this is a